¿Dónde está? ¿Y a Ocusa? Sacar aquí, ¿verdad? And all the dignitaries on the stage and few off the stage and my students' friends. So always I used to reduce my age, calling you as my friend. In fact, I've been prepared to deliver a lecture, especially on National Science Day, that to about Professor Raman, C.V. Raman. The time has been restrained, and we have devoted most of our time only on concentrating how to exhibit for exhibitions like this. Rather than speeches, I can motivate in encouraging the people to do lots and lots of sciences. And it was a wonderful day for two reasons. One is that I have been invited to this prestigious college's achievements on the National Science Day. And the entire credit goes to Sandhu Kumar, and equally the credit goes to Ramana. And I if I fail to attend to this, I'm failing my responsibility in encouraging you. And all the exhibits are so wonderful. Don't bother about the prizes that we have given. After all, it is only a 3 prizes. We have allocated for the basis of how they did it. And while explaining, principal has praised me that I have adjudicated the exhibits and each and every exhibit I have gone through. I'm sorry to say, a few exhibits which I cannot understand anything, only with the help of your principal, he is a zoologist. He knows better than what I know on his concept, and I asked him to exhibit on it. So, such a nice person, and I take the entire privilege in accepting all those praises. Probably my adjudication will be the correct one. See, coming to the actual Science Day celebrations, you all know Sir C.V. Raman. Whether I have any rights to talk about Sir C.V. Raman or not, that is a big question. But I can give you a hierarchy that I can stand up before you to explain something about Sir C.V. Raman. Raman's first doctoral student is G.N. Ramachandran. Probably the fourth doctoral student is S.K. Krishnan. In fact, S.K. Krishnan's work is acclaimed and that has been awarded with the Nobel Prize. That too about the scattering of light that everyone knows. And S.K.'s student is Baharullah. And Baharullah's research scholar is S.T. Thirunjana Sambandham. And Thirunjana Sambandham's research scholar is Professor S. Mohan. And Professor S. Mohan's research scholar is Professor S. Gunashekaran. And Professor S. Gunashekaran's research scholar is me. I am the third great grandson of Sir C.V. Raman. Probably, you are all the 4 great-granddaughters of Sir C.V. Raman. He was motivated only because of my teachers. If they discourage me, I'm sorry that I will not stand up before you to talk on this. See, this is how we have been motivated. Motivation is more important. That to address time with empty stomach is more important. Sorry, though we have stretched that because of number of exhibits that I have to devote at least 5 to 6 minutes to interact with them, and that takes this much time, and some of the experiments are so fascinating. And even the basic chemistry which we know is something different that they are explaining it in their That was so amazing. Right? See, in fact, some of you may know or may not know. I have to just quote a few things from Sastri Raman. Do you know Sastri Raman is an IRS officer? I don't know how many of you will be knowing it. She is the first chief accounting officer in the pre-independence day. The pre-independence days. And his first appointment was only at Calcutta, Indian Cultivation of Science. Before that, the institution was not trained, and he will be the chief accounts officer. Nowadays it is called IRS, next to IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS. So on those days it is called the chief accounts officer in pre-independence days. See, Raman basically from Tiruchirappalli, later on developed at the Presidency College, Chennai. And he has used a simple room in Presidency College where you can find a lot of dust. But his experiment should be a dustless glycerin. Today we have kept at Presidency College that room is a hiding place for pigeons and others. But of course, that will be useful for them. He has used a very, very simple experiment, only during evening times as well as during boring times. He hates the job, and people around him, including his wife, has criticized him not to leave the job as an IRS candidate. And he has gone to University of Calcutta, again in the same Presidency College. He serves as a physics teacher for a meager 60 rupees wage. It is not that I can claim it as a salary, it is very meager amount of 60 rupees. And he used to teach more on the vibration of sounds, how the sound can vibrate, and we used to demonstrate certain experiments based on the notes and anti-notes of the sound waves which can do. And after 7 years of struggle, he left the job, and he has been asking for a meager amount of 200 rupees to purchase a high purity glycerol. In one of the experiments where the chemistry people will be just like that pouring glycerol to have a welcome effect. See, on those days, for just 160 rupees, a pure glycerol of 600 milliliters cannot be afforded by Sastri Raman. And you see, there were nearly 7 people who mentioned about the same Raman effect without any proof. I can quote them. Smital is the first person who mentioned about the light can pass through a medium with the same wavelength. Most of the physicists will know. Next, followed by Raleigh. Raleigh is a mathematician. Later on, his interest will be devoted only on how to define the wavelength of any emitted radiation. And Raleigh unable to explain it with different wavelengths when it passes through different mediums. Again comes Stokes. Stokes is another gentleman who explained the same concept with the different notions. Again, he is unable to do. There must be some changes in the wavelength. This is what he said. Almost after 62 years, in 1928, Raman has tried to achieve with S.K. Krishnan, Karikamachari Krishnan. He is basically from Andhra. Both have tried to explain about why not the wavelength change should happen, as mentioned by Smital, as mentioned by Stokes. Almost 639 hours of patience. How many hours? 639 hours. An ordinary candlestick light, just a candle light, it is just like this. And you have one converging lens. The other one is a cross with a high purity glycerol. Those days it is called the glycerin. And on the other side you have got a broken telescope. And the telescope can roam around only for 60 degrees. See, but we need for 180 degrees of transmission. Raman took 2 places to identify the platform for a telescope to rotate over this. 7 years of rigorous research work has paid him a simple thing, what we call it as, there must be a change in the wavelength. This change in the wavelength has been proved by Sir C. Norman with the help of his students. Dear students, the extreme credit to the teachers is one million because of the students. If there is no S.K. Krishnan to Raman, we should not celebrate National Science Day on behalf of Raman. It is because of the student that the Raman have been celebrated. And remember, every teacher should have the pride if your students will behave like this, or if the students can achieve to the greater heights, greater and greater. So this is how Raman have done. And you see, when Raman is walking to Sweden on the central part of Gustav, King Gustav, then it's a funny thing. I don't know whether it's the right time to say it or not. Before the announcement of Nobel Prize, Raman booked a voyage ticket 7 months before it. And his friend has criticized, "Do you assure that you will get a Nobel Prize this time?" Raman is so confident. "I have booked a ticket to Norway, that means Sweden, and definitely I am going to get the Nobel Prize." 7 months before he had booked the ticket. On December 10th, there was an announcement, and that announcement has been reaching it nearly 6 days after the announcement. On December 16th, Raman receives a letter stating that your contribution to this society has been awarded with the Nobel Prize. So 7 months before he has come, he has gone there to receive the Nobel Prize with the King Buddha's hands, and he's standing before it. He is the only person with a covered coat and a turban. Don't see that this is a guest house room and I've got a Nobel laureate and you're not being the educators for it. He's the only person who receives the award. By the time, he was thinking two ways. One is that this Indian government has not supported for the research. I hate Indian government. This is what his mind wise says. The entire Europeans on one side, the Americans on the other, and the entire nations on the other side, all will raise up to clap for a Raman to receive the award from the King Gustav. He was so emotional. And the tears running down, and he was simply says, he is not bowed his head to receive the crown. Though he is a tall man, he is not bowed, assuring that the Indians should not bow for any cause. And King Gustav has raised the robe just by putting a garland to him. The moment that clap from the Europeans, from the Americans, and from the other nations, Raman has just realized that he is representing poor India by the time India does not have even a national flag. We just see, when we are ruled under British, we have got two Nobel Prizes. One for Rabindranath Tagore, it was for a literature, but that is not being considered as a great prize. The first Indian scientist was given for a very, very simple concept. Raman effect is a very simple concept. Though Raman has not used his spectrometer, do you know that we are all using Raman spectrometer, but Raman has not used it. He has used only a Anderson clamp and an ordinary telescope. So, such a thing, when he is representing for it, he was so amazed that India will emerge as a great country because of this Nobel Prize. See, he has got a lot of awards. The first award, the 9th Bachelor's Award. By the time he has been married with 2 children. But the award name is a Knight Bachelor Award in 1929, immediately followed by a huge medal award from England. That is in 1930, and of course in 1930 the other greatest award is a Nobel Prize. See, I can quote only one instance on this before my completion. As I said, I will be completing exactly in half an hour. See, it was 1954. Raman was called to give the Bharat Ratna by President Dr. Rajendra Prasad. This story really inspires me. In fact, twice it was mentioned by my father. Later on, it was mentioned by Dr. Abdul Kalam in one of the meetings at IIT Madras. He has mentioned it in 2003. See, it was 1954. Dr. Rajendra Prasad has invited Sir C. Raman for a Republic Day celebration. By the time he has been to be awarded with the Bharat Ratna. See, if I am being called immediately with another quote, I am ready to go with it. Because it is the highest civilian honor in an Indian government. Raman is politely writing a letter to Rajendra Prasad stating that, Mr. President, I decline honestly your invitation to attend the Republic Day celebration. Being a good teacher, please underline this, being a good teacher, I should be with my present scholars whose PhD thesis to be submitted by the end of December. the end of January. See, this really inspired me that I can see most of the cases, my teacher, Professor Gunasekhar, he is so humble. I never treat him as my teacher. I treat him as my father. Whatever I can ask to my father, the same I can ask to him immediately. He never criticizes me. You just see, even Bharat Ratna is not a big prize to Raman. But his intention to be with his research scholar who is going to submit his thesis on January appeared. So this was quoted by Abdul Kalam in one of the meetings. Later on, it has been published at the Hindu on Science and Technology columns about Sir C. Raman. You just see, I already mentioned, it is because of the student that the teacher has received a Nobel Prize. In turn, the student has given the same prize, the name Bharat Ratna, to his candidate. After 6 months, a special function has been arranged in the year 1954 during July and August. President Dr. Rajendra Prasad has presented him a Bharat Ratna. So these are all the few things that I can motivate a younger generation to go further and further. So this is a general audience, not only for physicists. It also comprises of the chemistry, the mathematics, so on and so forth, with biochemistry, etc. and so forth, including computer sciences as well as computer applications. See, there are two prizes. For mathematics, it is not Nobel, it is Nobel. The same Norwegian government, from 2001 onwards, they will be giving the highest prize for the mathematics contribution, which is called the Nobel Prize. For the computer science, it was a professor from Manchester University, who is Turing, who is giving Turing Award to computer science. So, every association is ready to give prizes. And we have two hands always to receive it. See, remember, if you are getting one day a stage like this to receive the honor, by the time you should remember me that I have triggered your scientific temper as well as the I take this opportunity to thank the management and my beloved friend Ramanan, Professor Yakub, and all the dignitaries including Silukumar, inviting me and and honoring me at this occasion. And the second important thing is, today is the day I have joined in this service 6 years before. And of course, I waited for 11 days to join only on the National Science Day, when it is supposed to be on the 28th of February. Though my appointment was in January, I waited for nearly 11 days to reach this on this distribution. So with this viewers, I can appreciate you, I can motivate you, and you people will nurture years to come and get a good name to your representing college. Even today, when I am just walking to Sachepa's college, I never seen the flow of that college. Always it will be like this. It elevates me. So, as years goes, this college will nurture and more capable students will come from this institution. And I wish you very all the best for your future as well as for this institution. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your very inspirational speech, sir. Next, at the end of the function,